Fast and the Furious 7 was a massive hit and was accepted and loved by audiences all around the world. And now Vin Diesel steps into his new role as the Last Witch Hunter. And I'm going to make a small review right now, so see you on the other side. What's up YouTube and welcome back to Showtime, and let's kick off today's show with a review of the 2015 movie The Last Witch Hunter, starring Vin Diesel, Michael Caine, Rose Leslie and Elijah Wood. Now, without giving too many spoilers away, Vin Diesel's character is a witch hunter, like it says in the title of the movie. And he's been cursed in the past, and he can't die, and he is walking the earth, and he's killing off witches, and he's like a policeman, which is, you know, going around and controlling the witches and making sure that they're not using their magic against humans. So that's more or less the plot, without going too deep into spoilers for you guys that haven't seen the movie. And the supporting cast members do a great job. I was convinced. The visual effects were spot on, and the directing, for the most part of it, was good, satisfying. But my problem lies with the screenplay and the pacing of the movie. For me, it was very sluggish in certain points. And for me, it was a missed opportunity. And what do I mean by a missed opportunity? Is it would have been better if it was produced by Netflix or Amazon Prime. Because you're jumping from the past into the future in this movie. And it is original. But when you have a movie and you only have a certain amount of time to explain the background and have character development, if the screenplay and script isn't written very well, the movie's gonna suffer. Now, yeah, many of you would say, look, it's just an action movie. Come on, Wayne. You don't have to go too deep and criticize it. Yeah, you're right. But I'm just saying it could have been executed in a better way, or a better script, or a better screenplay. And with a rich character like the Last Witch Hunter, it would have been better if it was a 13 episode season, and then if it's well received by audiences, then it could go on to other seasons, and we could see really more about this character, because it is an interesting character. So yeah, I'm just gonna rate this movie with a 5 out of 10. Of course, if it had a better screenplay, of course I would give it a higher rating, and I'm sure that all you hardcore Vin Diesel fans would disagree with me. And I like the guy, I love the guy, he's one of my favorite action heroes, but it wasn't his fault, it was just an error and pacing issues with the script. So thank you guys for tuning in, and if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And one more thing before I conclude this video. Somebody, I heard the doorbell ring today, and when I went down to see who it was, there was a special delivery for me, and somebody sent me a rose. So I don't know who you are, but thank you so much for thinking of me. I've never received a rose in my life. It's the first time. So whoever you are, thank you so much. So guys, see you very soon on Showtime. And if you love my review, subscribe to my channel. Have a great day. Have a great evening. And I'll see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.